Hey everyone, thank you for this opportunity. We are from Yahcom Emergency Unit. I'm sorry, we have no presentation slide, but first I want to tell you that the National Disaster Management Agency in Indonesia has recorded 1,805 disasters during January to August 2021, in which more than 98% were hydrometeorological disasters. The risks are even higher when combined with the other challenges such as poverty, gender inequality, environmental degradation, food and water insecurity, and the other disasters. We can rely only on managing disaster. We also need to manage disaster risk. In this case, climate risk through community resilience building. Since 2015, Yahcom Emergency Unit, with the support of the Hauriyo Commission, has assisted more than 60 grassroots women groups in 44 villages to support their local resilient action. Women are often seen as vulnerable. In fact, women have local knowledge about their community as they spend more time in their neighborhood. Community access to flexible financial resources like community resilient fund, however, is still challenging. Flexibility for us refers to allowing local communities to determine how funds will be best utilized to advance their resilience needs. Typically, when communities gain access to financial resources, these are already earmarked for specific activities. This leaves communities without a voice in determining how to use funds. Investment through Community Resilience Fund was adapted as both a learning tool and flexible funding mechanism to support communities' urgent needs, allowing them to manage the fund on their own. For CRF investment for the women group, the funding granted is $1,000 to $2,000 American for each group, where 50% of them is allocated for capacity building, like risk mapping, peer learning, and others. And 50% is managed to develop their priorities action. To manage funding, women group collectively map their risk, capacity, and priorities that help them to identify resilient action. In this process, they build consensus that leads to collective action. Bookkeeping training was helped to help the organization and administrator to control and allocate the funding for group operational, member income, and social data, which is reported to the member every month to keep the fund management transparent and accountable. The contextual and specific action led by grassroots women result in more effective adaptation. The biggest loss due to uncertain climate is full. So often farmers do not have the capital to continue farming. By managing a group resilient fund for climate adaptive agriculture, women groups have reduced the impact of the map risk and found the best way to mitigate and unpredictable season for agriculture activity. At the same time, engage closely with the government for data validation and exchange information about one another. Based on the priorities arising from mapping, resilient practice ranging from small-scale grocery shop, seed bank, waste bank, aquaponic, urban farming, climate adaptive farming, and others were introduced. This local action by grassroots women demonstrate the capacities of women as change maker. Change maker is, in this case, meaning that they are able to leverage their role in the community and strengthen their contribution in development and adaptation planning. Indonesia has a decentralization policy or regional autonomy that requires local participants and enable decision making at the regency or local level. But only a few local actors especially among women, are involved in the planning process and rarely make meaningful contribution that address the vulnerabilities in their mapping, training, resilient initiative, per-learning, and dialogue with stakeholders deepen their understanding of organization skill that make them eligible, accountable, and help women gain recognition as leaders who represent local community and influence the adaptation planning. As a result of the initiative, 80% the groups have registered their organization to the village government structure. 90% of the groups have their members serve in the leader's position or be a part of decision maker in the community. Managing action to manage disaster risk, and 80% successfully participate in the village budgeting planning. The Melati group is one of grassroots groups in Indonesia, Yogyakarta, who made significant resilient improvement through initiative using the CRF mechanism. So she is Ibu Warsila, want to tell you when you want to share you about his activity in Melati group.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Perkenalkan, nama saya Warsila, Ketua Kelompok Wanita Tani Melati, Dusun Watu Gajah, Girijati, Purwosari, Gunung Kidul. Pada tahun 2019, kelompok kami diaktifkan kembali setelah vakum 10 tahun. Kami didukung oleh YU dan Hero Commission dan mendapatkan dana ketahanan komunitas. Kami bersyukur karena sejak saat itu kami jadi tahu tujuan dari organisasi kami dan kekuatan kami sebagai perempuan, sehingga kami punya kesempatan untuk membuat kehidupan menjadi lebih baik lagi. Dengan mengelola dana ketangguhan masyarakat dan menjalani prosesnya, kami sekarang memiliki pengetahuan, informasi, dan kemampuan, sehingga kami dapat menyampaikan ide-ide kami dan terlibat dalam berbagai kegiatan di desa. Kami telah belajar bahwa banyak dan antusias kami telah mengundang banyak dukungan. Kami bekerja sama dengan Balai Penyuluhan Pertanian yang membantu kami untuk meningkatkan kapasitas sebagai petani perempuan, melengkapi dokumen administrasi dan persyaratan pendukung lainnya, yang membuat kami berhasil menerima dukungan dari pemerintah dan berkontribusi pada perencanaan program Dinas Pertanian melalui aktivitas-aktivitas konsultasi. Sejak melakukan pertanian adaptif iklim, kami menjalin hubungan baik dengan pemerintah desa kami. Terima kasih kepada Bapak Lurah yang selalu mendorong kami untuk mengirim proposal dan menghubungkan kami dengan pemangku kepentingan lainnya. Saat ini kami memiliki 23 anggota yang mengelola lebih dari 10 hektar lahan untuk menanam padi umur pendek dan komoditas palawija unggulan di wilayah pesisir, menggunakan pertanian adaptif iklim dengan menyeimbangkan antara menerapkan metode pertanian organik dan atau menggunakan lebih sedikit bahan kimia. Praktik ini merupakan upaya untuk menjaga kesuburan tanah agar pada saat musim kemarau tanah masih memiliki nutrisi. Kami telah mengikuti 14 sesi pelatihan dan mendapat 9 program bantuan dengan nilai total 97 juta. Kami mengalokasikan 10% dana sosial di desa kami. Praktek kami mengundang kelompok tani perempuan lain di desa kami untuk melakukan kegiatan yang serupa dan meningkatkan organisasi mereka. Aksi-aksi kami dan dengan dukungan dari pihak terkait telah membuat perubahan besar dalam kehidupan kami secara pribadi. Memperkuat hubungan kami di masyarakat, meningkatkan pendapatan rumah tangga, dan meningkatkan ketahanan terhadap bencana. Kami ingin memperkuat organisasi kami dan terus terlibat dalam sisi pembangunan desa untuk memastikan bahwa aksi adaptasi perubahan iklim dan ketahanan diprioritaskan. Terima kasih atas waktunya. Mohon maaf apabila ada kata yang salah dan kurang berkenan. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Terima kasih Bu Warsila. So, based on our experiences, giving the power to local communities is not worthy. We can see how the local community, like women in rural and urban areas, which are most affected by climate change, is greatly important and experience immense change by managing the resources. Recognition of the local group is very full, helpful to give them confidence and allow them to access every support that will strengthen their capacity